Maybe have a parachute for safety or something. Huh. Oh, what happened? Welcome back, Khonius here. Today I thought I would take a pleasure trip around my area of the woods. I live in Pittsburg, California. My closest airport is Buchanan Field in Concord, so I consider that my home airport, even though I don't actually fly. I chose this very strange aircraft from Microsoft called a Volocity. I really have no idea what this is going to be like. It's got a whole ton of propellers. So it's sort of like an enormous drone or something. I don't even really know how to fly it. What I'm expecting is the throttle will just give me altitude and the stick will let me navigate around. But I guess we'll find out. I have no idea what's going to happen anymore. Okay, so this is the inside of the aircraft. See all those propellers spinning. There's not a lot in here, but it looks like it has a pretty sophisticated glass cockpit. So that's pretty nice. Alright, well, let's see what happens. If I hit the throttle, maybe I'll lift off. Oh yeah. Wow, that sounds really trippy. Not sure how fast the throttle can be pushed. I've got it all the way forward now. Alright, so let's push the stick forward and see if we start moving forward. Looks like we are moving forward. Alright, I'm going to pull off the throttle a little bit. I'd rather stay a little closer to the ground. Alright, so I'm pushing all the way forward, trying to dip down. Very strange, but there's no reason why something like this shouldn't work. I don't really know what's powering all this. Is it maybe electric? Wow, very trippy. But I wanted a slow speed aircraft. I tried a couple of flights with my ultralight and the game crashed. So that content may be having a problem. And I remember that there was this really strange looking hovercraft kind of thing. Oh, look at that. This is the local drive-in movie theater down here on the lower left. And that's actually still in use. Got very popular when the pandemic hit, and still popular. I've never been there myself, but sometimes at night you can see a movie playing on that screen. Okay, this pretty much flies like you would expect. I guess it's kind of nerfed or modernized. Just the stick kind of moves you in the direction you want. Now, I'm rotating a little bit. I don't know how to counter that rotation. I'm trying to rudder, but there doesn't seem to be a... Oh yeah, I guess there is a... It's responding to my rudder. There we go. It seems a little more normal and less crazy from the inside. I'm gonna pull back on the throttle a little bit. Okay, so this would be Highway 4. This is the route I take to get home. Still need to use my rudder to turn here a little bit. Some kind of weirdness going on with the road here where it becomes a wall and cars are going through it and things. It's kind of strange. So AI didn't really construct that properly. Now I think if I throttle all the way up and push forward, I should start moving quickly direction. That's what I'm expecting. Still gaining altitude, so I'll pull back on the throttle a bit. I'd like to stay a little lower to the ground so I can see everything. I'm gonna use that rudder to stay moving in the direction I want. Land over here on my left that looks like a golf course. I guess maybe there is a golf course there, but there's also an old Navy base on the left. I think you can see that over to the left with Quonset huts and things. And then on the right, well, first of all, show the left side. So there's the golf course, and then there's the old Navy base, Concord Naval Weapon Station. And on the right side, we've got these ammo dump containers or something. So you don't ever want to go there. Alright, I'm back on the throttle a bit. So yeah, this is Highway 4. I go up this hill to get home. This is Willow Pass Road. It's not really ever that busy, and also it doesn't cross directly into the oncoming freeway traffic. So that's pretty funny. Wow. Okay, I need to throttle up because we're dropping a little bit here. I'm kind of getting the hang of flying this thing. It's very odd, but I like it. Fits the bill for a helicopter-like vehicle. But you kind of got to watch the throttle. Those little propellers are very powerful. Alright, so we're coming over the hill into Bay Point. Level up and drop in altitude a little bit. See if my forward momentum can carry me for a while. It's interesting because we're driving at about a legal freeway speed here. Okay, turned a little bit too much there. Kind of hard to adjust that while looking back. This pretty much flies intuitively though. I'm not having much trouble learning. But this would be a very strange thing to see flying over you on the freeway. I guess I don't have an automated co-pilot. Housing development that I've been seeing go up for a while. Looks like it's still being partially built according to this photogrammetry. Not sure what this water thing over here is. I don't think I've ever seen that from the freeway. Oh, wow. And there showing a lot of water in this canal, but I think it's pretty dry with the drought and everything. Okay, this is a BART station, Bay Area Rapid Transit. Look at those tracks are in the middle. Over here on the right is the supermarket I usually go to, Safeway. If I can get close and see the logo on the plate. Yeah, there's the Safeway logo. It's kind of scrambled, but a little hard to see. Maybe I can turn around and get it clearer. It takes some getting used to maneuver this thing. But anyway, there's the Safeway logo. Actually, it looks worse than I've seen before. It's been easier to see in the past. Alright, I'll continue on my way. So that's Bailey Road. There's an actual BART train parked on the tracks, so that's kind of cool. Again, a lot of water in this canal that isn't actually there, but I suppose if we have a flood. Alright, let me get back onto Highway 4 over here. You can't, don't seem to be able to take advantage of your altitude in the same way as you can in an aircraft. I just drop, I don't gain any forward momentum. I definitely want to stay clear of these power poles. Try steering from the inside, that might make this a little easier. I can imagine we'd be freaking out the drivers if they saw something like this overhead. So somewhere there should be Railroad Avenue. I think that might be the next one. Hard to tell exactly where it is. I don't know if we've missed it or parts of the stuff doesn't look so familiar. Okay, we're gonna have to give it some throttle and push forward and get some speed going here. another BART Bay Area Rapid Transit Station at Railroad, so I think that's coming up right over here. That's where I go to one of my favorite jack-in-the-boxes. This weird thing happened yesterday, they were out of tacos. I've never had a jack-in-the-box be out of tacos in my entire life, going all the way back to my childhood. I don't know if the jack-in-the-box will show up here or not. I can certainly try to see it. Down there to the right, below some trees, maybe that green building. And then the exit after Railroad is Leverage. Okay, so this is Leverage. That's my exit. See if I can get down even lower here. If I let off the stick, maybe I can get to the point where I'm hovering evenly. Find a nice hover altitude. And then I'll need a little bit of extra power forward momentum. But if you look on the left, you can see these tanks, and there's an air gas company here that makes, I guess, carbon dioxide, nitrous, or liquid nitrogen, and whatnot. It's one of the ways I recognize this exit. There's also a Walmart here. So let's see if we can spot the Walmart. I love the fact that we're going so slow. Wow, that looks just insane. Yeah, I think I did good with the finding the right hover altitude first. Okay, so somewhere is the Walmart. I think it's this building just right directly below us. Yep, that's the Walmart. Not sure their logo will be as well. I see Walmart down there on the ground. To the right, to the right. Question is, do we see a Walmart logo on the front of the building? It's a little dark. There's also a Wendy's and a Popeyes there. Okay, I need to get my bearing to figure out now where I am. Okay, so there's Leverage Road, follow that. It's very handy using the rudder on the stick. You can do everything with the stick very conveniently. I doubt this is what it feels like flying a helicopter. This feels much more like it's a modern, specialized flying craft. Okay, there's that flooding again. It doesn't actually exist. And then this big shopping center on the left has a shut down supermarket, back to the DMV office, which is convenient because I can walk there if I need to. Starbucks in that little box down there. Okay, so now we're heading into my neighborhood. Now I need to get a bearing to see where I'm at. I think this is the street here. Yeah, this is it. So there's a school on the right side there. It's an elementary school. I'm going to try my hover altitude. I don't want to hit any trees. Okay, I need to, I'm not trying to be over the school, but just a little tricky maneuvering this thing. I'm trying to get back down following this road here. Okay, I think I turn left here, that's my street. Yeah, I see a big camper there. There's a guy that parks his camper there all the time. Oh. I hit a tree. Yeah, there's a guy that parks a camper all the time. So that kind of looks like his camper. I don't remember to keep the engine going. Okay, I think I see my house. I live on this street. I recognize some neighbor's cars, just barely in the photogrammetry. The way I usually drive out of there. Do not want to hit the power pole. This is an RV park over here that I never actually see from the ground. It always looks like it's probably pretty ugly, and looking at it now I would have to agree that it does look pretty ugly. Okay, and so let me head off to where I go to go shopping, which is this direction. Again, they're showing all this water here that doesn't actually exist. I'm not sure what this thing over here on the right is. They keep working on it. Looks like some kind of a processing plant. Maybe sewage or something. I do not usually have to drive through water to get through here, like it shows here. of silly that it's so hydrated. Okay, so we're about to enter the city of Antioch, leaving the city of Pittsburgh. If I remember, throttle go up. That's my elevator. So this is the cannon, okay. And Somersville Road. So I'm going to turn on Somersville Road. Heads into the big shopping area. There's Smart and Final here. You can kind of see their logo on that building. See a very clear Smart and Final logo. There's a bunch of shops over there. Here on the left is some real mall. I've never actually been there myself. That Macy's you see there, that actually shut down when Macy's closed a bunch of stores. And then here's the intersection with Highway 4. And then past here is where the shops are, Costco, a bunch of stuff. There's a Target, In-N-Out. Harbor Freight Tools, here's the In-N-Out, lower left, from lower right. Let's see if we can spot the Target logo. See it on the sign over there by the road. I think it's down there somewhere. Yeah, I see it. It's a Target thing. And then across the way here, there's a Costco. So it's Costco gas on the lower left there, and there's the warehouse itself. Probably go here, I don't know, once a week on average. Nice to see they have so many solar panels. Of car dealerships and stuff over here. I guess they call this the auto mall. Right below me, I think, is the Lowe's. Yep, this is the Lowe's. Go there from time to time. Trying to see their logo, but I think I'm a little bit too high off the ground for that. Yeah, I saw it back then. That's the mall I was talking about. A lot of parts of the area I haven't been to that I don't know much about. It might be worthwhile to fly over them and kind of take a peek. There's a giant garbage treatment plant and a bunch of other stuff. I know, this sounds just lovely. I don't see a moving rudder. I wonder if that's just a rotational thing with the propellers. Can I use that? So this might be related to the garbage stuff here. All those spin propellers, that's so insane. Whole watery area out here at a harbor. Been out there a few times. The area had kind of a scary vibe to it, so I haven't gone back. I don't know what that's all about, but I just felt I kind of got the heebie-jeebies, people staring in funny ways. Felt like I wasn't supposed to be there. Must be some kind of a smokestack or something. I don't know what this island is out here, where you can go onto it or... This might be a preserve. Looks like there's nothing on it. Out. It looks this watery in real life. Let's wait for the chase cam to catch up. See some other smokestack off in the distance and some other stuff over here. Not sure what any of this is, all industrial stuff. Tanks down there. On here. Okay, this must be the harbor down here. This is the area I was in that left me feeling kind of creeped out. But it looks nice from the air. See a bunch of boats and stuff. Probably oil tanks or something, I'm guessing. I houses right next door. Boy, I wouldn't want to live right next to those. It's funny how ugly it is with these tanks. I mean, you go a little bit over, you've got these beautiful canals with houses around them and things. It's kind of a lie. Kind of getting the hang of flying this thing. Just have to practice a little bit. Kind of hope something like this exists in real life. It feels so easy to fly that in the future it could be so automated that it's safe for anybody to get in and fly one. Kind of feels that way. Maybe have a parachute for safety or something. Oh. Whoa, what happened? I must have run out of gas. I thought I had unlimited fuel. Well, we'll end it right there. I was not expecting that. So I don't need to shut the engines off, although I'll make sure they're officially off. Looks like I ran out of everything. I don't even know if I can power off. Yeah, I don't seem to be able to end the flight. Anyway, this was a lot of fun until I ran out of power. It's probably batteries. So thank you so much for watching my Pittsburg, California tour in the Microsoft Volocity, whatever this thing is, helicopter or something or other. I don't know. This was a lot of fun. It sure bounced and landed nicely when it fell out of the sky. That was kind of cool. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to share it, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. I must have run out of gas.